Wow, man, I just don't even know what to say, man. You know, I was in the middle of making this video. I was editing it, and then I heard the news of Etika's passing, and then at first I tried to not pay attention to it, 'cause I didn't believe it was real. 'Cause when he uploaded that video, it's kind of even fucked up for me not believing in him, because I remember getting a notification that Etika uploaded that video, that 7, 8 minute video of him, well, of that was gonna be his last video. Well, I didn't know it at the time, and then I was watching a little bit of it, but then I just closed it out and then continued editing, because it just, I don't know, I just thought of it as another publicity stunt, and the fact that that's his last video now is just, man, just leaves a, man, it just makes me feel horrible for even ignoring it like that, for me just neglecting the situation like that, like, for me just, I mean, I know, a lot of you probably don't even know me. You know, actually, none of you know me. It's like I have what, 18 subscribers, like what, the maximum somebody's ever watched my videos is like what, 200, maybe not even 200, like 150 maybe. It doesn't matter, but I like, even though y'all don't know me, I just still felt kind of obligated to make this video or to even talk about this man's passing. And even while I'm editing, I can guarantee you that I felt, when I'm editing, when I was editing this video, I was feeling like if I didn't upload it immediately, then a lot of people wouldn't see it, and then I wouldn't be recognized. And then I just began to realize that this is exactly what Etika was talking about. And there was this other YouTuber who was talking about
Content creators
how about Etika's
need
passing too, and he
to
was
take care
talking
of
about
themselves.
how people can just become so
However,
absorbed in
you might
being
feel like you might own
noticed
a
and being
boat, or if you
always
don't
being
go on Twitter
up
or
to date
Instagram for even
and
one
staying
day
out of
and believe
irrelevancy,
that you're gonna
you
fade
know,
into
and
obscurity
doing
and
whatever
nobody's
they
gonna
can to
move
not
on
be
and not care
like
about you
obscure
and you won't be
to be
relevant.
recognized. And then I felt
But
that, just I felt like if I didn't upload this video immediately, then it just wouldn't be, just wouldn't get that many views. And then I finally underwent that experience of how, even though I don't have a viewership like them, but I'm still trying to be recognized out in this platform and attain a viewership. Maybe it's people who would watch my videos because maybe they find it interesting, you know. And then I felt just that urge to keep constantly editing just so I can have more views on it. So I understand now just what they were talking about. Anyway. I haven't, well, recently I haven't really been watching Etika all as much, even though in the past I used to be this big fan of Etika. I loved watching his videos. He always had like this charisma, this energy that he brought to the screen that just compels everybody. It's such an enthralling skill that he had. It just always seemed to captivate you with whatever he did, whether it be it like his outrageous, outlandish reactions to video games, especially Nintendo stuff like Smash Bros. His like those iconic videos he made, or if it's just
But she's such a loving
the
woman.
more
She really
quiet,
is. Mommy, I would
silent
never
ones
let
where he's
death
being
come in my
honest and
life.
true to
God knows I don't
himself
want to go through
and
death, man. I'm so
his
weary of
life
having
around
to.
him.
You know what I mean?
Whether
I'm
it's
so
one of those
blessed to even
moments,
have
you
that.
just,
Some people don't even
there
have
was
that.
always something
You
about
know,
Etika
I'm
that made him
blessed
feel so,
just to have someone like that.
just something about him made him feel so honest. And to see him, to hear about him just dies, it's just crazy to me. I don't have a lot of social media. I'm just not that kind of guy. So I just keep to myself and to the few people that I know. I just go off of that. I'm not really big on social media and stuff, so I didn't really understand what he meant by how it consumed him, even though I can't see why some people are just very addicted to it. But yeah, it just came out of shock to me, because I knew that he was going through a lot of stuff, and I just, like, I was turned off about, like, how he was handling the whole situation. And I thought it was just like, he made it appear to be a publicity stunt. And then after he did that a couple of times, I was kind of turned off by it. You know, to me it felt like he was just trying to get attention. And so I didn't really pay much attention to it at the moment. And even though I'm not as big as a fan as I was maybe 2 years ago when he was playing, well, the first video I ever saw him play was with Persona 5. And, like, that's what really got me into liking Etika, because that got me liking Persona 5 too, and I love Persona 5. It's a great game, even though he never finished it, and now it's sad to say that he probably never will finish it. Actually, not probably, he'll just never finish it. Those videos that he made were just the most, just some of the most entertaining. This nigga said you can't go after his most entertaining videos that I've seen, and I love those videos, and that made me become a true Joy-Con boy. That even though I didn't buy the merchandise, actually, there was a couple moments where I actually did donate money to Etika, and even though everybody around me thought that was just a waste of money, even I thought it was a waste of money to some extent, I felt like I shouldn't have been as carefree with how I was spending my money just donating to somebody when I obviously needed it, but I don't know, I did it anyways. Maybe it's just because how his honesty appealed to me that I just felt compelled to give him some money, to provide this man, this loving, fun, charismatic, energetic man, just some money. And I did. So, I was never ashamed that I did it, but now I'm glad that I did. You know, I'm just glad that I provided him with, like, that I supported him financially, that I was a part of his financial support. But that's besides the point. It's, man, I don't even know, man. It's just so heartbreaking just to hear that news. And yeah, what I've said before, like, I don't really have social media like that, so I don't follow celebrities or YouTubers or anything like that. So I just, and I can see why people who do have social media, because those celebrities post stuff of themselves onto it, how could they can start building some sort of a relationship, even though they've never met them. It kind of makes it more personal, and then the people watching their stuff become attached to them. I think Etika was the only one that I ever, I guess, made a bond with. Something that I've never done with celebrities in general. I don't typically do that. He's like one of the only ones that I felt close to, even though he's probably never met. Even though he's never met me, you know, I just felt close. It's just that personal. Like, things, you just get to see his life on a personal level because he's always recording and live streaming. Or he was, yeah. I guess that made me feel like I liked him more personally than other, like, celebrities who are just doing movies that I've never even gotten a chance to see how they are as people. Etika, I could see him living as himself, being an honest person. And so just to see the one guy that I had that sort of unique bond with is now just died. It's just I don't know. It's hitting me pretty hard. It's just hard to believe, man. And you know, when I even when I knew that they confirmed that that was his body that they pulled out of the water, and even when I knew that that was him, I felt like it wasn't even real. Like, I know that everybody says that, but I was just like, okay, let me just continue editing my video and just take my mind off of it, you know, kind of subconsciously thinking that to myself. And so I was editing the video, but even as I was editing this video, I was just left a bad taste in my mouth over time. It was just, the realization of that just this man is gone and I'm over here editing this goofy ass video about Bella Delphine. It's just stupid. Then my mood was automatically killed and I just left it alone. And now I'm just in this kind of state of processing this, you know? It's just, man. Rest in peace, Etika, man. Man, I hope wherever you are, man, hope you're just at peace, man. And I hope his family stays strong throughout his passing, man. Rest in peace, Etika.
Change? Shit. I guess change is good for any of us. Whatever it takes for any of y'all niggas to get up out the hood. Shit, I'm with you. I ain't mad at you. Got nothing but love for you. Do your thing, boy. Yeah. All the homies that I ain't talked to in a while, I'ma send this one out for y'all. Know what I mean? Cause I ain't mad at you. Heard y'all tearing up shit out there. Kicking up dust. Giving a motherfuck. Yeah, niggas. Cause I ain't mad at you. Now we was once two niggas of the same kind. Quick to holler at a hoochie with the same line. You was just a little smaller, but you still roll. Got stressed to YA and hit the hood swole. Remember when you had a Jerry curl, didn't quite learn. On the block with your Glock, trippin' off Sherm. Collect calls to the tilt, saying how you changed. Oh, you a Muslim now, no more dope game. Heard you might be coming home, just got bail. Wanna go to the mosque, don't wanna chase tail. It seems I lost my little homie, he's a changed man. Hit the pen and now no sinning is the game plan. When I talk about money, all you see is the struggle. When I tell you I'm living large, you tell me it's trouble. Congratulations on the wedding. I hope your wife knows she got a player for life. And that's no bullshitting. I know we grew apart, you probably don't remember. I used to fiend for your sister, but never went up in her. And I can see us after school, we bomb. On the first motherfucker with the wrong shit on. Now the whole shit's changed, and we don't even kick it. Got a big money scheme, and you ain't even with it. Knew in my heart you was the same motherfucker bad. Go toe to toe when it's time for growth, you gotta pump us back. And I can't even trip, cause I'm just laughing at you. You trying hard to maintain, then go ahead, cause I ain't mad at you.